Hi, and welcome back to a very special Miscellaneous podcast. I'm your host, Polly, and tonight we have the Miscellaneous Misfit. No, that sounds bad. We got to redo this.
Yeah.
It's you and me.
Yeah, it's just me and you. It's the Polly and Kira Adventures.
Yes. The Polly and Kira Adventures?
Yeah.
I like that. Let's larger the picture, too, so we look more official. All right.
This is episode two, no?
No, we haven't. Well, we started doing them before, yeah.
Yeah, because this would be episode two.
Because we went to Casey, Illinois.
Yeah.
Went to the fan expos.
But we haven't really published, you know,
an
episode two, so this would be episode two.
All right. Should we just look at the camera because we can see each other there?
Yeah.
But we're so used to, like, trying to look at each other.
Oh, right?
We're dorks. Hi, and welcome to another zany adventure of Kira and Polly's Adventures. I don't like this.
I don't like
it. We got to figure something out. But today is a very special, special show for me, and I think for you too, right, Kira?
Oh, yeah, it was.
Because we went to go see Gabriel Iglesias. Love the flair we have here. We have our limited edition. Well, it's a collector's item. Salsa, hot and fluffy sauce. We have our hoodies. We also got t-shirts.
And I got my book bag.
Yeah. Can you grab it or is it out of the way? It's a Funko Pop. It's amazing.
A Day of the Dead.
Mm-hmm. Now, if anyone's out there listening or watching, I don't know how to say it, and would see this, they would know where they're at without telling you where they're at.
They know.
They know?
Okay. Yeah, if they know, they know.
Then they know, then you know. You know, you know. The cool thing is I think I can move this in the middle. Oh, shit. I'm just messing everything up. We're going to get through some stupid pictures here real quick.
Why do you have all these pictures?
Because it was supposed to be for the show, but the show was whatever. So, I'm going to try to move this to the center of both of us. There we go. How's that?
Okay, so.
We went to go see Gabriel Iglesias. There he is right there. In St. Louis?
Yeah. Okay. So, but we got to start from the beginning.
Okay.
If we're going to tell a story, we have to start from the beginning.
Okay.
That's the only proper way to do any story.
All right.
We have to be honest.
Well, start it then.
Okay. So, I think it all started when actually I watched a TikTok of Gabriel Iglesias' last special on Netflix. And that's when he was announcing he was retiring are going to retire at the end of 2024, which I was like, dude, I have not yet seen one of his shows.
Are we starting from there or are we starting from the way beginning? Because, like, if we start from the way beginning, we can talk about how we first saw him. If anybody doesn't know who Gabriel Iglesias is, he's not, I'm not fat, I'm fluffy guy.
Oh, yeah, we'd have to start from the very, very beginning.
Yeah, because I don't want to, though. That's what I'm saying. Do we have to? I don't know if we're going to do that or not. I don't know if my microphone is in the right place. Oh, well. But, he was big with the I'm not fat, I'm fluffy.
Yeah.
And he had a lot of cool jokes, and he always talked about his friend, Martin!
Yeah, and, when I found out he was retiring, I was like, I have not yet seen one of his shows yet. And, I know every once in a while, last year he came to St. Louis, and I didn't get to go one of his shows, and I was disappointed. I was like, and I am not missing it this time around.
Mm-hmm.
And, I didn't tell you I was going to go buy tickets. So I was...
Yeah, because normally you go, babe, how much do you love me? And it's always something like that. But you didn't do that this time.
No. For the St. Louis City Soccer and Gabriel Iglesias, I bought them without you knowing.
Yeah.
Because I didn't want you to know the price tag.
Yeah, they were expensive, yeah.
But it was definitely worth it. In my opinion, it was worth it in the end.
I agree, yeah. So this was at the Enterprise Center here in St. Louis, which is our hockey rink as well. And when she told me we were going way back when, for me, I'm like, all I know Gabriel Iglesias is from just the HBO specials, friends that saw something on social media and told us, you know, that kind of thing. So I didn't really when you said we're going to go, I was like, oh, okay, whatever.
So, and when I've watched all of his Netflix specials and how funny as hell he is, And, like, I can relate to the dude. Like, you know me, Polly. I'm a foodie. So, like, you put food in front of me, it's like...
It's on, like, Donkey Kong?
Exactly. I don't eat ice cream. I inhale it.
No, I know. Yeah, I know. That's why I made a pledge tonight not to buy you any more shit. You gotta buy your own.
But, like finding out he's retiring at the end of 2024, you know, I was like, I want to at least see one show.
You want to move it closer?
But, like...
There you go.
So, like, afterwards, I'm thinking, don't make plans for this day.
Yeah. I remember when you first kind of said it, too, you were just like, you know, oh, this is the date. And I kind of like was like, okay, whatever. You'll just remind me. And as I got closer and closer, a buddy of mine gets a hold of me, Leroy, and goes, hey, I'll also be at the Gabriel Iglesias thing. And I was like, oh,
he almost forgot, too.
Yeah, yeah. Because he actually texted me, like, are you still going? Like it's a party you can kind of, like, just go away from. I'm like, yeah, no, we're going. But he got the sweets, and that was amazing. Now, we're not going to get into too much detail about a lot of things, you know, for privacy issues and stuff like that. But I will show you, which I do apologize. All these are out of order. this is great.
Hey, what do you say we sing a driving song?
Some say love, it is a river that drowns the tender reed.
So when was it that you finally came to me and like, hey, I got these tickets?
Okay, so it was actually during lunch.
It was, yeah.
It was during lunch because I was thinking.
Because I was in shock.
Yeah, because you're like, why? Why did you buy these tickets for me? Why did you spend this much? Like, for, you know, on me kind of thing.
Yeah, and your answer was, because you do so much for me, babe. And that just made me feel like a guilty son of a bitch.
Huh?
All I'm saying is that
when you grow
it makes you feel uncomfortable when your girlfriend buys you something really, really expensive.
And like, and it's funny because the generation we grew up on, think of it that way, because
yeah,
we grew up with the generation where
we're still trying to look at each other.
Yeah, I know. and it grows up the generation we grew up in that the male was always the provider.
Yes.
Then that. Matter of fact,
and I don't have nothing against that either.
No. Because it's how we were raised.
Yeah.
And, like, it's funny how it ties back into some of the jokes. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, it's just things have changed so much.
Yeah. And be mindful, too. At this time, I found out about Chicago, right? Was this finding out about Chicago?
Chicago.
Which was hundreds of dollars.
Indianapolis. The cruise that we're going to go on?
No, I'm talking about like the ones you spent the huge amount of money on.
Oh, yeah.
Not to mention my birthday gift of William Riker. That was like a big one, too, cameos. So, yeah, I'm your bitch. Why are you trying to drink? Oh, yeah, I've been ordering it. I was like, what are you doing off camera for? No, my name is Paul. All right. Yeah, so you tell me I'm like shocked, whatever. Like I said, I only watched his HBO stuff, so I was like, whatever. And even the day of, I was just kind of like, okay, I just want to kind of walk around. I never really saw this thing and blah, blah, blah. Because there's like, I'm like,
But you were excited that Leroy was going to be there.
Yeah.
Lavender was going to be there.
Well, there's a big mindset to all this, too. Because as a content creator and everything, and we just now got into this video thing and we're trying all this out, which I really love this light and everything. It's really nice. Everything's illuminated now.
I tried to tell you.
But you know what I'm saying? It's like everything's kind of coming into this new thing. And
yeah,
I like it.
And you were hitting a phase where you weren't even sure about the podcast.
Yeah.
The future of the podcast. Because you're like, I don't know if I want to do this anymore, you know?
Yeah, because I would spend hours editing audio. And I'm watching people mass produce these shows and being on video and all this other stuff. And I'm like, I want to do this. Why is this so hard for me?
And you're kind of at a point where now where you're, you can't spend so much time as you used to.
No, because I have an active lifestyle now. It sounds like one of those bad Viagra commercials. He has an active lifestyle. But it's true. So I went from, and it's funny because the lady who writes the Harry Potters and stuff, she said this too. She's like, you go from being in a room all by yourself with this idea and you're writing and writing because you have nothing else going on in your life to being in the limelight and, you know, going out to shows and being all respected and everything like that. And Stephen King kind of talked about that too in the very beginning when he got his drug addictions and everything. But I get it now, not because I'm famous or anything, but because when I met you, mm-hmm. we literally were like Wyatt Earp and that chick, if mm-hmm. her name was, where they just started going around, just going everywhere. Mm-hmm. Because what was it, like not less than a year that we were together, we're already having like, you know, weekend excursions to Branson.
Yeah,
and
I would say Branson. We did the NASCAR race. We know we went to Chicago. I mean,
yeah,
we did
my first Indianapolis
twice.
Con. No, yeah, we went to three different cons in 1 year. I mean, we just got busy. Not to mention, like, she's a handful.
Dang.
Oh yeah,
pull me out like
she
that.
Is, but so like it's just fun. We're doing stuff, Pazuba Guabo. It's fun. So being cooped up in a room for 12 plus hours editing and creating these things, and I'm really proud of everything I've done, but we're talking about Gabriel Iglesias.
Mm-hmm. Orale! Yeah, sorry, we kind of went off on a tangent.
But yeah, I was in a mindset of a lull with my, you know, this is a hobby and all that stuff. So yeah, so when I was going to this, I was kind of like, and then Leroy got a hold of me and he goes, we have the suite. I was like, okay. So he's like, I'll be there. I'll come down and visit you guys or whatever. So we're now the day before we went to the Mad Hatter, which we spent 0.25 seconds there because it was raining and cold and like we had to park blocks ahead of time, like out there. And I'm like, I'm not walking this shit.
Too freaking cold.
Yes. So next day we have Gabriel Iglesias.
Inside.
Now, inside, we go into the oh, it was so beautiful, okay, because parking in St. Louis is a nightmare, and it's expensive, and it's probably dangerous, depending on where you go, and that's just the harsh reality of life. So we get down to the Enterprise Center, and they have their own garage, and it was only $20 to park. So I was like, yeah, let's do that. Andy, get inside,
yeah.
Pulling right in, and yeah, it was nice, and there was a lot of people there. I mean, it was packed. And then Leroy, I called him up to see, like, where he was at, what he was doing. And he goes, I'm getting in the garage right now, too. So
you're like, oh, yeah.
Yeah. So he used to have a white vehicle, like a little white Chrysler. So I was telling her, yeah, when you look for a white Chrysler, Bazooka Guava, whatever. And then he pulls up in this black SUV Lincoln. And he's like, hey. And he, like,
Lavender Mobile.
Yeah. The Lavender Mobile. He looked like a black Matthew McConaughey, like, when he does those commercials.
Yeah.
So he pulls in. He hangs out with us online because he's the bougie guy who has, like, oh, I can go in wherever I want and I can do whatever I want. So he was out there just hanging out with us for us little peons until he saw our seats. That was amazing.
Okay, so when we had to go find our seats, we had to show the people our tickets. Leroy could not go where we went because
he could not go where we go. So our tickets were on the ice, like literally
before.
Where the ice would be. It was great. And it is weird because now I played ice hockey back in the day, and the whole challenge was if you can stomp your foot down and break the ice to the paper, which is about that thick, right? That thick, okay? We're already down to the wood, so that thing's probably like 3 feet deep, maybe 2 feet deep, whatever. I don't know. It was just funny.
But our seats, we had really good seats. We were in the middle section, five rows from the fifth row section from the stage.
Yes.
So we had really good seats.
Yeah, if you see this picture right here, it is, yeah, that's how close. It's not, that's not from a screen. That's the smoke that was bellowing up. And this was at the end of the show because they were telling us when we first got in line, you can't take pictures, you can't use your phones, you can't videotape. when we got to the first set of the what is that called? The portal to get out.
Mm-hmm.
Don't use your phones. Don't use it. You can't no pictures, no videos. We're getting like so many people are stopping us, telling us this. And then when they came out, Martine was the first to come out, the first act, and they were saying it too. In between the second act and then to him, and even Gabriel Iglesias was like, please, no cameras, no filming of any sort.
But there was a good reason for it, though.
Yes, because it was all new material.
Which was awesome, by the way.
Yes. So I kind of took a liberty of my own, and this picture right here is of Martine. That's the illegal picture I took. Nah, I'm just kidding. He told us to take our phones out to get the QR code for the if you look up there, it's the scan code now. It's for the thing. He said, yeah, take your phones out just this once, and it was really cool. Now I want to talk about each act one by one, if you don't mind. But let's finish where we started out as.
So we're going to have to talk about the intermission break before Fluffy's act, because something happened in between. Because we can't forget about what happened in between.
But this is a view right here from the suites where Leroy was at. So he's not hating life either.
No. But he had a nice suite too.
But you see up. Hold on, I'm trying to get this right here. Okay, there we go. So that's the stage right there, and so just five rows back, center stage is us. So we literally could like spit on him. That's how close we were. It was great. So we get in and we go through the portal to get into. I'm gonna keep this up because you could see like how big the crowd was gathering, and this is before everything happened.
It was pretty much almost a sold-out show.
I think it was. Yeah, because the only seats that weren't available were the ones parallel to
the stage.
The stage, yeah. So I think it was sold out. Oh, shit. Whoa, that's loud. All right. So,
You okay?
Yeah, it just kept vibrating in my ear. So we get through the portal. We start going down. And Leroy's like, so Leroy left us. And then we got it. We had to go through the metal detectors and all the good stuff. And you're like, I want to get my souvenir stuff soon, babe. And I'm like, yeah, no, that's cool. So let's find our seats first. We were looking at all the – they had. It was kind of like the St. Louis soccer place. All these venues everywhere to get food and drink and everything. And they're about the same looking too. And we get through the portals, and we get down, and we find – well, Leroy passes us in the thing. We're like, Leroy, hey, okay. So he goes, I'm going to go wait. Where's your seats at? So we go, and we're looking into the seats, and we go and down, and Leroy gets stopped.
Yeah, that was where I was like, oh, shit.
Yeah, he can only go so far. And it was like down – I can do this with my right hand. Okay, left hand. Right down about here area where you see the railing from the picture, that's where you come out of the portal to go into the ice. And that's where they stopped him. They're like, you can't go. And he's like, oh. And I was like, well, we just want to show him our seats. He goes, nope, you guys can't be down there. Okay, whatever.
We wave.
Yeah, so we went down there and we found our seats and we turned back and we waved at Leroy and he's like, those are some nice seats.
Motherfucker.
So then we head back up, and we go up to where we're at the suite because he wanted to show off his suite. So we get up there, and it's dimly lit in there. It's like a friggin' nightclub, and there's some people around or whatever. And we're drinking, and we're like filling up on – we're putting beers in the backpack. Oh, but that was the old backpack, right?
Yeah,
no,
it was my Loki backpack.
It was the Loki backpack, yeah.
Because I didn't have a backpack before then.
Yeah. And then, what was it? Before the show started, we got the swag,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
By the way,
It was during intermission.
Was it intermission?
It was intermission.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, wait, we just went back down to go and sit and... No, we went and got food.
Yeah, we went and got food.
Yeah, we got chicken fries and that was... Yeah. We should have got popcorn or something.
Yeah, honestly, I think the St. Louis City Soccer had better deals with their food and venues.
Yes, they didn't have... Yeah, St. Louis has unlimited soda, which is really good. Oh.
But the food was okay. It was a meh.
Yeah, soda was... it's everything. It cost me $53 to feed you. I know it sounds weird to say that, but for two drinks and a thing of cheesy chicken strip fries. It was kind of weird. It's like chopped up chicken strips into fries with cheese on it. That was $53. No.
You can admit it yourself.
Yeah, no, yeah. But we just, it's part of the venue, just part of the experience. So Martine comes out. It was really cool because the shade goes down and it has all the...
So the screen itself was like a throwback to the 90s.
Yeah. No, we can't say too much.
No. But okay. We're giving you a general idea of what the theme was about.
Mm-hmm.
But...
Yeah, it was a throwback of the 90s. It had like the play thing. It was showing old reruns of his shit.
No, it was advertisements.
Oh, yeah, it was advertisements, yeah. Because we were like looking at that. I remember that. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, and then now we were literally like pushed in like sardines. Like they fit us so much in that middle area. And for the price, we even were joking around, like for the price of these tickets, man, we should have had some more room, you know? And
not fat guy friendly.
It was not fat guy. No, it was not.
I'm always like, oh, I'm sick of it.
I'm so feeling bad for the lady next to me because she's like scooting over because she's itty bitty. Like, there's room. I'm like, no, there's not.
I felt bad. I was thinking, oh my God, am I scooting over enough for you, babe?
Yeah, it was bad. So I had to put my arm around her. And look, arm around her and like hold her to me for us to, you know, was that her? But it, yeah, that, but it, now here's the one thing too. I cannot sit still.
No, I mean, that you is, cannot.
Yeah, I always
you're
have
like
to constantly adjust.
You're like a kid on like 80, you're like eight with yeah. ADD.
Because like we're at a movie theater, so I want to get up and I'm going to go to the bathroom. I'm going to roam around a bit. I'm like, yeah.
Gotta put a leash on you.
Better put that thing on a leash, sir, or I'm going to have to fine you.
Take your stinking paws off me, you damn dirty dog!
Yeah. So it was hard to kind of, like, because I was drawn immediately when Martine came out.
Oh my gosh, yes.
So the axe opens. We're not going to explain too much, but, no. Like, Martine's comedy style was great. He's a great storyteller. And it was...
I could relate so much to him, though.
Yeah, I don't know. Can we talk about his stuff?
I don't know.
I mean, I want to talk about his stuff and the other guys, but not Gabriel. So how about that? So if we get in trouble, hashtag St. Louis nipples. That's my savior right there. Martine said that. I put it on his Instagram. That's part of his...
So, like, we can vaguely describe what he joked about.
All right. It was a lot about...
generational differences.
Yes.
And how they handled it.
And they were good. They were funny as hell. And a nipple was involved.
And positive body images.
Yeah. I love how when he first came out, he goes, all right, is anybody sensitive here? You can leave. Like, I forgot how he said it.
As soon as he said that, I think, oh, shit, this is going to get good.
Mm-hmm.
I better get I'm glad I went to the bathroom earlier.
Let me go back to Martine here. Yeah, and it's really hard to see. You'd have to, but he looks like, God, I don't know how do you say it now? Can you say, you
like a wizard?
Yeah. So he goes, part of the thing, he goes, you see this here with my beard and my hair? This used to be sexy, but now I look like a wizard. And everybody's laughing. And to me, I felt like he looked like the Big Lebowski.
I'm the dude.
He looks like a beach bum. Yeah. And he's just doing his stuff, and he sounds a little bit like Gabriel Iglesias, too. And like I said, he was out for a while. It was funny. It was very I really like how it was very based on stuff that happens nowadays,
yeah,
and what we're going through.
And I like how they don't hold back. I like that kind of style.
Yeah. And then, like, immediately goes, anybody offended? No? Okay, we'll keep going. It was fun. Yeah, it was amazing. And
if we had shit, I want to invite them to and just say, here, tell me stories.
Oh, yeah. Fun. I would kill to pay for just those two to just sit down and see how their dynamic is next to each other.
Yes.
So
give us a few drinks and let's go.
Mm hmm. So then he came out. He did it for a good half an hour or so, an hour. I don't know.
Time flies.
Time flew because I was so. Yeah, I was having so much fun. And then he goes, all right, so you guys want to run out, do some stuff real quick? Next act is coming up. Or did it come up right away? I forgot.
It came up right away. But when he had to leave, he was like, oh, shit.
It was bad. They're like getting ready for the next guy. And the next guy was Matt something or Mike something. What was his name?
Matt something.
Yeah, and you've seen him on HBO and other Comedy Centrals and stuff like that. But he's kind of a, not to sound like an asshole, but like he's kind of not really, you know, whatever. But he was funny. He was not funny like Martine.
Here's the thing. All comedians have a different sense of humor. They each have their own unique style.
Yeah.
And that goes for people in general as well. Everybody has their own unique. I have a broad flair. Yeah, I have a broad sense of humor. So to me, they were all funny.
I look like a fat Jeff Rogen in this hoodie, don't I? I feel like that.
I live with you. I'm not gonna make a comment.
Yeah, I do. I do, don't I? I look like a fat Jeff Rogen.
But
I'll take that. That's a compliment.
I loved his raunchy jokes. I'm sorry. How you killing the same joke three different ways?
Oh, that was so funny.
I know, right?
So he's talking about, okay, we're going to get explicit here. Screw it. He's talking about like a tampon. And this, it's a bar joke about putting alcohol in a tampon and, you know. And then he tells the first story and you're like, oh. And then he stops and he kind of looks around. I could tell it a different way. Really? And then he starts going and proceeding to do it three times.
Different indies, and they're all worse than the first time.
Oh, my God. Yeah. So, like I said, he was funny, but you're just kind of like, oh, it's gross funny, you know? It's like, ugh. Do you ever heard of the amazing Jonathan?
I think so, yeah.
He's the magician one. That does the gross thing, like stabbing his tongue with a needle and stuff. You know what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. And then, like, he'll be like, it's just a trick. But, yeah, so like you said, I'm circling back to when you're saying that, you know, you have all these different ways of comedy.
Yeah.
But I like the storytelling one because it's all frameworked on, like, and I know this is not his either, but, like, Robin Williams is a storyteller.
Yeah.
Gabriel Iglesias, Martine, a lot of other ones are great storytellers that have the comedy in it. But I think Robin Williams did a lot of history, too, and Eddie Izzard and all those. Like, but I love it because, like, Martine and Gabriel were telling, like, stories of their life and putting the comedy to it. And that's what I really like about their style.
And I feel like Gabriel just had like a normal, ordinary day, and something happens to him. He's like,
"Yeah,
what the heck?
Dude? Oh my God, yeah!"
I feel like he was like, "You can have a normal day, and something."
Yeah, just boop. That's what happened. Knocking at your door.
Like when you were at the casino, or when you and Leroy have your like heydays at the casino.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, it's funny because like we talked about the casino. So Leroy and I worked at the casino together, and
I apologize for bringing up old employees.
Yeah, no, that's fine because we can't talk about it much anymore. But as we were going through, when Leroy passed us and he's like, "Here, I'll go see where your hat's here," we met another casino worker. We knew another casino worker, and I was like, "Oh my gosh!" When we were leaving, that girl came up to me and is like, "Polly," I'm like, "Hey," I forgot her name. I felt bad. It was Kelly, but I mean, I was like, "Oh my gosh." So it was crazy.
It was like a reunion.
Yeah. I didn't know that many people liked Gabriel Iglesias. But so once he was done, they had a pause. They had like an intermission. They said, stretch your legs. You need to go to the bathroom. He goes, we don't want to be rude people.
So they did a thing where if people paid $500, they could get a meet and greet.
Oh, no. Back that up. Okay, so they talk about the intermission, right? And then you're going to take a little break. While they're doing that, all of a sudden he goes, since COVID, we haven't been able to do this, but we're starting to get back to it. And he holds up these backstage passes, and he had like five of them or whatever. And then he goes, in the corner over here with Hector or whatever. What was his name?
I think so.
I forgot what his name. And we're like, yeah. We went over there, and everyone rushed the stage. I mean, it just... and we were like elbowing people to try to get through and everything.
Like, yeah.
And we're like, what's going on? How much is everything? And we don't know what's going happening. And then all of a sudden this lady's fighting her way back to us. And she's like, $500 for one. I was like, oh. And Martine is saying, it's for two people, a backstage pass for two people. And I think you get like a good 5-10 minutes with them. And I'm sure we could take pictures and everything. So you were like, do you want to do it? I'm like, I guess. So we're trying to rush our way into it. And it is getting chaotic. And
so the crowd was getting ridiculous. It was like a mob. I mean, it was an uncontrolled mob. Like, I seriously thought I was going to get trampled on because I'm so short.
Dude was pushing me from the back, and I'm like elbowing him and like, stop. And this lady comes out of nowhere from behind us going, I've already bought it. And I need to get to the front. And me and like this other guy were like, how? Is there a QR code we're missing or something? Like, how did she get to that fast? And I guess her husband was already at the front, and they paid that way or something. And at that point, that's when you're like, you know what, screw this.
Yeah.
Because everybody had their phones out trying to like click on something. And
I was like, fuck, pardon my language, fuck this.
Yeah.
It's not worth it. It's not worth the stress. It's not worth the $500.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? We're here. I paid $500 for our seats.
Oh my gosh.
You know, you know what? I'm just going to go get our souvenirs and call it, you know, a show, a day, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah. Now, I think I'm glad we didn't do that. Now, I'm not saying I think I am. I think. Well, no, it's good that we didn't.
Yeah, it's good that we didn't.
Because I grabbed your hand. We got to the back. We went up to the thing, and then we were in the line. The line went pretty quick, and I have her name, the lady who was at the So we get to the booth, and the lady, man, she looked like not mad or
she
like
was
how
exhausted.
Customer service is nowadays. No, she looked she looked exhausted, and I felt bad for her. And I told her I'd give her a shout out when we do the show. Seriously, Paul, where is my stuff?
Look up yourself.
Yeah, I'm just gonna look up myself. So we're in line, and we're struggling, me and her, because we're trying to figure out
what we need.
Yeah, what we need, all
or
that kind
what
of stuff.
We wanted.
Yeah. So her name is
Patrice.
Patrice. Yeah. I'm sorry if I butchered it. But she was awesome.
Yeah, she helped us out a lot, and God bless her heart.
Now, it was funny because we're going in there, and she goes, Jamie's like, do you want a hoodie? And I'm like, and she goes, I think they have them in your size. That is a big thing for us big guys. Most places we go to, we have to get – they only go up to 3X or 4X tops.
Yeah, so I knew – see, and that was another reason why I got Gabriel Iglesias tickets, because – I knew he would have stuff in your size.
Yeah.
No offense.
No, and I like big, baggy stuff already.
Yeah.
So being a big guy and you want big, baggy stuff, that's a big bill to pay.
And if anyone understands the struggle, he would.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Oh, yeah. So I was like, cool. And we get in there. And so this is my Christmas present. Thank you, babe. Kisses. So we got the T-shirt. You got a T-shirt. You got two hoodies.
Book bag.
Book bag.
Hot Funko.
Pop Funko, signed Pop Funko,
mm-hmm.
And this I bought.
Two of them.
Because we didn't know about this. I saw it up there, but I didn't really think anything of it.
Mm-hmm.
And we went to the show where Gabriel came on, and they mentioned that these are collector's items. And you won't find them on eBay because they won't sell them on their official websites or anything. They're exclusively for each location they go to. Which is a great selling tip for you to, you know what I'm saying? To like go to where they're at because there might be different ones.
Because they're cutting out the middleman.
Yeah. But this is the old school hot sauce guy, and it has a little Fluffy hugging him.
So hold on, I'm gonna see if he has them on the site.
All right. So we get done with that, and like everybody there, I felt so bad for them at the thing, because I was like, "Do you guys get to sit? No, we have to stand." And it's like, okay, you see how our table's here? It was lower for them, so they had to fold the clothes, and oh man, I felt so bad for them. And I was like, "You guys get like 15-minute breaks, like every 10 seconds?" Said, no, we have to go. And then when the show starts, then we sit down and we're chilling because there's no one coming around. But Man, they looked miserable.
Mm-hmm.
But they did a good job. They did an amazing job. They're all nice. You just tell they're wore out.
Oh, yeah. And, like, God bless their hearts.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Bless your hearts. I think you say that when somebody's, yeah. So, Leroy and I were kind of keeping in contact as well. But then we had to go to the bathroom. So, we got our bags. We were consolidating stuff. We're putting, you know, everything in this. Can you reach over and grab the bag? I want to show it. Yeah. Just, yeah.
The struggle is real.
And we were just putting stuff in the bags. And we were taking turns because there's so many people there. So, we kind of took our turns going to the bathroom. All right. So, this is the Day of the Dead backpack style. So,
I loved it. I wanted it.
Oh, it's so cool. And it's a Funko Pop.
And I've gotten
too.
A lot of compliments on it, too.
Yeah. It is amazing. There you go. So we fill that bag up. I mean, we filled it up. We're putting everything in it so that we could, you know, consolidate. And then we're going to the bathroom. So I went to the bathroom first. And dude, this is like any you've been to the ballpark games. Yeah, the bathroom lines are ridiculous. So I get a text from Leroy. He's outside smoking. And I'm trying to figure out where he's at outside. And it happened to be near us, near where we're going to the restroom. So I go over there. And, you know, we hang out for a quick minute. We come back. Okay, and we're, like, on the exit side of the bathroom.
Keep in mind, I'm in the bathroom. So I don't know any of this stuff.
No.
So we had a rendezvous point where we meet. So, like, he met me. I went off the bathroom. So I still think he's there. Well, they're doing all this. So, and Polly's not the one person who stays in one location. He likes to run around all the time.
I do. I can't sit still. And so I was like finding him. Okay, so here's the thing. The way the bathrooms are set up, they have a designated entrance and an exit. And you're supposed to go in, do your duty, and then keep going straight out. Well, I was like, she's going to come out the exit. She is law and order. That's all she is, man. She's very eins zwei. So I was like, we're safe here. So we're talking and whatever. And then I see coming straight at us at a fiery pace, a pale Kira and just mad as hell. Like you could see the nostrils flaring, the eyes glaring. You know, she's just...
Leroy's like, oh, shit, you're in trouble.
Oh, yeah, dude. He's like, you fucked up. He's like getting behind me and everything. And she's like, yeah. Right.
Keep in mind, Leroy's like, what, 6 foot?
Yeah, Leroy used to be a bouncer. So he's like 7 foot tree and just built.
And I'm 4'11". Yeah. I'm a short-ass woman.
Oh, yeah, and he was scared of you. He's like, you fucked
short
up.
Short-ass white woman.
Yeah.
You're in trouble, dude.
And you're like, and I'm like, it's okay, calm down, we're right here. We thought you were going to come right out here. I mean, I'm doing everything again. And she's like, rawr! Just going at me, man.
Oh, shit.
That's funny.
It's a comedy.
Yeah. So we get back to our seats, which are very cramped, very uncomfortable.
It is time for the main event.
It is time. And
the man, the myth, the legend.
Yeah, they did that. Oh, what did your shirt say on it anyway?
Okay, so I get a Gabriel Iglesias shirt says love, laughter, and cake, which is perfect for me.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know,
you like it all.
You know, when you have love and laughter in your life, you know everything's going good, but cake makes it even better.
Tasty!
Oh. You had to add that Demon Slayer.
Mm-hmm. So he comes out, and he comes out with a boombox. Like the picture you see here.
Are we even supposed to talk about that?
That's as much as I'm really going to go. He comes out with a boombox, and he has his shirt on and everything. And he's like...
Man's got style, man. I don't care what anybody says. The man's got style. The man's got flair.
He's all that, yeah. And he goes, hey, everybody, hey, St. Louis, all the normal stuff. And then he goes into the spiel about, please, do not film, no phones, no nothing, and don't yell at me on the stage. And he goes, I have brand new material, so I don't want it out yet. We're working on it, we're experimenting with it, and he is such a great presence that you're like, right away understanding, like, yeah, there's no hecklers, there's no nothing. Except for one. One lady dared to challenge Gabriel. You remember that?
Oh, yeah.
So, and it was the very beginning of his thing. He's talking about this and how life is like what we said earlier. Like, so much happens all of a sudden in his day, and then he goes through his story, and this lady yells out, Wheel of Fortune. And she is, where that picture is at, she's just to the right, and I think in the front, the very front row.
Yeah.
And he looks down, and he goes, yeah, Wheel of Fortune, you saw that. Don't yell at the stage. He goes, I'm not a trained like Mary. Like, and I was like, oh my gosh. It was so cool how he addressed it at the same time,
yeah, he,
and acknowledged it at the same
yeah,
time.
Yeah, he really knows how he's done this for so long. I think he really knows how to handle it. Really
yeah.
Now.
Yeah.
And you can tell.
Yeah, and it was just, and it was really cool because you're like, because like when she first blurted it out, I mean, that little child in me who like, follow the rules,
I know,
no. And
I
then,
know, right?
Yeah. And like, you got yourself in trouble, you're gonna get kicked out. And he's like, yeah, you saw that, yeah, just don't yell at me. You know, it's like awesome.
I'd be like, the person next to you would be like, oh my God, how could you?
Yeah.
Shut up.
But then he went on this really, really cool ass thing about the Wheel of Fortune spinning the wheel. And he's like, dude, you guys think that this thing is like, you know, and he's using his voice like, because he's talking about, yeah, you think you could spin that thing because on TV, it looks like they don't spin it fast. And he's talking about how like in Wheel of Fortune and in, what is it, The Price is Right? Like you'd just be like, yeah, just like spin that thing. He goes, those are heavy. And he goes, you're like, oh, I just turned off my back. Oh, it was so great. Because he went on this tangent about it. Not a tangent. He's told a story, you know,
yeah.
Whatever. And he went through all that. Just, you know, it was really cool. And then he got right back into his set again. And that was really cool. Yeah. His stuff, oh, my gosh. We can't talk about it because I don't think we can still talk about it.
No.
Because this happened, what, last weekend?
Yeah.
So
yeah, his tour is still going on. So no.
So we were, you and I were talking about this ever since then because it started as the show progressed, I started kind of seeing myself in Gabriel.
Yeah.
And not in a weird, condescending way or weirdo beardo way, but like his style kind of matches a lot of what I do.
That's what me and Leroy were talking about too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when you and Leroy both kind of made it, said it too, I kind of felt good, and just watching him and doing his new stuff and everything, it just flowed so well that it reminded me of like how I do my stuff. And I was like, this is amazing. This made me feel so like revivified again. I mean, I was energized.
And he's like, and you can tell he's a down to earth person.
Yeah.
And
oh yeah.
And like, and he's just, I don't know how to explain it.
Yeah, we're doing a piss poor job of reviewing his shit. By
I know,
the way.
I know, right?
We're giving it no justice.
No, it's not. It just, we can never do it justice for the type of person he is. The worst part is we've not even met him in person.
No.
And like we can tell just by him acting and being him,
mm-hmm.
We can tell.
Because, like, when you see it on HBO, and, like, you can say this about anything. When you watch a baseball game on TV, but then you actually go to a baseball game, there's a whole different perspective.
Yeah.
When you see Gabriel on HBO, it literally is the same that you see him live. It's him doing the stories, walking back and forth constantly. The guy never stopped moving.
But I think it's better in person than it is watching on TV.
Oh, anything's better in person, yeah.
I mean, I would spend...
Anything.
I would spend the same money again to go see him again.
I don't know about all that.
I would.
No, I would pay more. I want the front seat.
I'm going to have to pay more than you do then.
Okay, why? You want to sit up on stage with him?
I'm...
Jeez, how far can we get this? I'm going to hug him while he does his set.
Shut up.
Start dancing and shit.
Are we having a competition? Who can pay more for his tickets?
No.
I lose. Yeah, because you're broke.
Yeah, I am. I hate this. Waiting for my first paycheck, it sucks.
But,
oh, man. But it was so, it made me really... Okay, so as a podcaster, I've been doing this in 2017, and I've I was able to accomplish a lot of the things I wanted to do, my personal goals, which is amazing. But, like, seeing everybody do these things and get, like, listeners and all this other stuff, and you're bombarded with everybody all over social media with all these different things and everything going on, and then you have the your cancel movements and all this other stuff, and everything is so exposed everywhere and viral that your stuff that you do feels insignificant and you feel low. And then going to Gabriel Iglesias and talking about how lucky – he kept talking about how lucky he is for doing this for 22 years – or something like that, 20 years, 20 plus years of being the stand-up, and it's literally just stuff that I do, in a sense. I'm not trying to say anything like that. It's just like, it made me feel okay to be me. And Gabriel Iglesias is good at making you, like, laugh at your own problems and laughing at his problems because you can relate to them, and that's what makes him an amazing comedian, an amazing person.
And, like, and when
that's all I got on that one.
And, like, that his last story when he was talking, about, which we cannot talk about.
Mm-hmm.
But we're kind of.
Are we talking about the pumes?
I'm talking.
Because I liked how you went, like, that reminded me so much of my dad. And you and I were talking. Yeah.
We can't talk about that.
We were talking about it off camera, obviously, and we were like, how are we going to do this? I want to talk about it. And I was like, we can't talk about it.
So there's so many jokes of his that we can relate to because we've been politically corrected by so many people so many different times. There's certain things that, you know, we're like, oh, you need to do this, blah, blah, blah. And like, I've got this. I'm good.
Mm.
Kind of thing. And but, you know, his last story about Chris Rock and David Chappelle.
Yeah. I don't think we talk about that either.
No.
That's as far as we can go, and yeah. I think that was too much.
Yeah.
He met celebrities.
Yeah. But that story, like, seeing that side of him.
Yes, and how humbled he was by it. And how he was taken aback about that. And that's the same thing with me, too. Like, when I meet a fan or... Well, yeah, a fan, anyone who listens to the show, and they break it down to certain things they liked about my stuff, I related 1,000% with what he was saying about those two,
mm-hmm.
about what they said about him, and how he was like, why you will, like, he, oh, my God. God, I wish we could talk about it.
I know, right?
Oh, my goodness.
But I only said those two because so you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, and please don't sue us.
But, like... When he was talking about that story, he kind of seen the humbleness and like in all the stories he was talking about, it was like he didn't hold back who he was.
No. I mean, he was talking about personal things that was happening to him. And I never knew that about him. I didn't know half this stuff. Because I do like how like there's a lot of celebrities that are like, this is my private life and this is my... You know, the other life, and there are two separate things. And he did a good job, at least as far as I know, because we don't like in-depthly like follow this guy either. So,
like I knew about the whole. I can't say about this part because it was a worldwide thing, but the airplane crash, I knew about that.
Okay, we can talk about that.
Yeah,
one?
Because was a worldwide thing. So that's everybody.
No, I forgot. Was he in the plane when it crashed?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. They said they took off and then they had to land away or something?
That was in the news.
Wow.
That was in the news.
What happened again?
So they decided to private jet and...
Yeah, I remember saying that. And right when I said private jet, I'm thinking, oh, my God, it's Ricky Valley. Oh, my God, who's Big Bumper? Who is
As soon as he said private, I'm thinking, oh shit, this is gonna go bad. This is gonna go south real quick.
Didn't like the wheel fall off or something, or what happened?
I don't know. I have no clue exactly what happened.
We're prepared.
I know, right? but it also, you know, it's part of his story, so it's probably a good thing that we don't remember.
That's good. Yes, because it yes.
But anyways, but as soon as he said private, I'm thinking, oh shit, here we go. That's the reason why that was your first mistake, private.
So one of the things I thought was really cool is about midway through his stuff, he's talking a lot of just amazing things I always said. And I started looking around at the crowd because I'm a people watcher.
Mm-hmm.
And there was nobody. There was only maybe two people I saw who got up and moved around. That was one guy you could tell who went to the bathroom, and then the other guy went to go get more beer. Everyone else was glued to Gabriel. And, I mean, granted, for the price of the tickets, I would be glued too. But with that said, it was still amazing how much the attentiveness was there. So, I mean, he's a great storyteller.
Oh, yeah. And, like, shit, I would definitely go see him again. And I then highly recommend he tells go us, see him.
Huh?
I highly recommend go seeing him if you haven't.
Yes. I give it a 1,000 thumbs up. And this thing right here, whoosh.
And the hot
this
sauce
right
is
here
good.
Was awesome. When he first told us like this, it was at the near the end of a show, and he goes, if you guys haven't got it, get two of them. And we did.
They so, made it, I kind of like the joke that they made about that one, too.
I love this. This is so funny. Yeah, because he's like, put it on eBay and get your money back. So they're probably going to be on eBay right
and
now.
And I told Polly, buy two, use one.
Yeah, buy two, use one, sell the other one.
No, collect the other one. Don't even open it.
So we just, yesterday we had a barbecue. We had a Mario Kart tournament barbecue. That was awesome. Gabriel, you're always invited for our barbecues, just saying. Martine as well.
Yeah, you better not forget him.
Yeah. And we used the hot sauce, and it was amazing. I, however, did a bad thing. I drowned my hot dog in it. Not a good idea. Don't drown your hot dog in hot sauce.
First mistake.
Yeah.
Hot sauce and ketchup combined.
Yeah, I mixed it together. Oh, that hurt. It was really good.
Next thing you're going to do it with tacos?
Yeah, we got to do it with tacos now.
Taco. Grande.
Whole parade we got to do it with.
Yeah.
We have tacos, fajitas, everything that sounds racist. We got to stop. All right.
Yeah, I know, right?
Yeah.
We keep doing that. We're going to get.
I don't want to get canceled. I'm a fat Joe Rogan. Canceled! I really like this hoodie. It is so comfortable.
I know, right? What do you think? I wore it the next day and you're like, no!
Yeah, I can't wear this to my job. This will really tear up. I don't want to do that. It's special.
Babe.
Thank you. This is my good Christmas present. Thank you.
You push boxes. I clean bird poop.
And that's as far as we can tell you.
That doesn't sound right.
It was really good. And leaving was fun, too, because it didn't feel like we were racing to get out or going through bad streets to get out. So it was a pleasant experience from start to finish. I wish we could redo it all over again because it was such an amazing thing.
I wanted to hit the reset button.
And like what I said earlier, I want to bring back into it again because on the way home, I was digesting everything you guys are saying because you brought it back up again as we were driving home. And you're like, yeah, you can't stop. This is good. And so I want to thank you, too, you and Leroy, because now it's look where we're at now. This is nice and bright and we can see everything now and this is good. And we actually have visual aids. Like, I want to do the rest of the shows like this.
So we're going to do a cruise episode, you know, when we're on our cruise this coming New Year's?
I don't know. Maybe. Can I bring my laptop with me?
I mean, if you can stuff everything into your hoodie guy and take it on an airplane.
I mean, we can do that, right?
I don't know. Are we going to get stopped by the TSA and Homeland Security?
That would be a good story. All right. Stay tuned, everybody. Thank you so very much for listening and watching and everything. And thanks again, Gabriel, for coming to St. Louis.
Thank you.
Look, self-made entrepreneur, no manure. I'm number one. Goose down, jacket, maverick, top gun. Do it, B.I.G. like Biggie, big pun.
Do me a favor, turn on your flashlights, and I'll show everybody where we're at tonight. Where are we? Thank you.